Good evening, everybody. Am I audible to you?
Ah, yes, sir.
Sir, am I audible to you? Okay. Please unmute yourself if you want to raise a question. So welcome to the third meeting of GMC and Meerut Medical College alumni. We had two wonderful meetings previously, and today we are having a very wonderful speaker with us. Previous two meetings were well attended by students of all ages, Dr. Kakrari, Dr. C. Thomas, Dr. Khare, Dr. Shamsundar Doshi, Dr. Satish Khadilkar, Inamdar and Vivek Redkar, and many more. And the presentation given by Dr. Manohar Inamdar was appreciated by practically everybody. It was pain, brain, and physician's brain. Today we have got a very wonderful speaker with us, Dr. Shamsundar K. Doshi. He is a clinician radiologist, and what he told us that for a clinician, radiology is the third eye, and that too it is a very energetic, joyful, and very simple way. DMRD in 1976. He joined Mission Hospital, One Less Hospital, 1976 to 1978, when we were students. He went to PGI Chandigarh from 1978 to 1980, and there he stood first in the Department of Radiology. And actually, I feel that he is the person who has really seen to our batch. Our Meerut Medical batch of 1974, he came back again in 1980 to Mission Hospital. Till that time, we passed, cleared our MD from Meerut. He joined Krishna Medical College, then he subsequently Hubli, and today, right now, he is a pro vice chancellor of SDMCS in Dharwad. The excellent clinician, a dedicated academician, a great human being. Sir, I hand over the mic to you, and you please start your presentation. I am stopping sharing of my screen.
Can you hear me, all of you? Can you hear me?
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Loving introduction. And I compliment you.
My phone.
Collect all the members of Meerut Medical Center. And less hospital. And I'm very proud that many of our senior colleagues are also here. Many of students and my association with the Department of Radiology and MMC is very memorable, and I even now cherish all the sweet memories. Joined there, and some of them, Dr. Khare, they're all very close friends and senior colleagues. Dr. Sorto, Dr. Santmur, Dr. C. Thomas were guiding us. Thank you very much, sir, Dr. Thomas. VN Desai, one of the representative students, is also here. And being associated with that, in fact, whatever that I am here presently, it has a major contribution from MMC. I quote Meerut Medical College incidences on many of the occasions in administration, also while talking to students, and those memories are very fresh. And let me come to the topic for today. Is something which is unusual and not usually read even by radiology students. I'm very interested, only focally interested in history they will read regarding the some of the points which I'm going to convey you. Dr. S.V. Kulkarni had given me topic and past, present, and future of whole imaging. It's a huge topic, so I thought of dividing it into. So I'm taking the evolution of the conventional imaging first and then go on to imaging. So every bit of it, there will be one last question. That is now a question me. One piece, X-ray will be there, and it will be your opinion. Now let me go to my presentation. Knowledge of history changes our outlook towards better understanding our experience, like the past we are dealing with. I hear a lot of noise. Good evening, friends. From SD College Medical Science Hospital, and also University of Chennai. I hear a lot of noise here. Lot of noise even now. Yeah, noise is there. Okay. Even now. Now this is the campus where I am working at present. This is a huge campus of SDM University, and this is the General Hospital, this is Specialty Hospital. This is Medical College, the ground, and all the boys' hostel, girls' hostel, and this huge auditorium. On this side, we have a nursing college, pharmacy college, and this side, we have a dental college. I welcome all of you to visit the campus. It works, and you really enjoy it. Now, today's topic, initiated by the sentence, Journey Through the Evolution of Medical Imaging. This is the lateral view of my campus. You can see the same building. Now, I'll give you one clinical scenario. A 59-year-old frightened woman admitted with dyspnea and severe right chest pain. On percussion, it revealed dullness. On auscultation, poor breath sounds on right side. Parameter, loss of vital capacity. Now, with this history and clinical presentation, the physicians approach before the imaging and after the advent of imaging, lot of difference.
Yeah, what's the
meaning? Would have gone ahead with concluding the diagnosis of pleural pathology, massive pleural effusion or empyema based on history and all. He might go ahead with some more invasive procedures also. But after the advent of imaging, the approach greatly differs and he goes initially from conventional to later if required for further imaging investigation. Before that, the guided, he might find out what pathology is going inside. The medical practice before the imaging facility, that is between 1750 to 1850, it was purely of five senses, medicine and five senses. Looking at the patient, listening to the patient, palpating and percussing the patient, sniffing and tasting the patient, direct auscultation. These five senses, even more, they are very important. Unfortunately, the training going through blunting of these five senses and has the clinical acumen of the budding doctors is reducing. That more and more they all the other investigation rather than their own length of senses perception. Someone has not muted.
हेडफोन काढला तर माझ्या असा काही आवाजच नाही. ठीक, मी
दुसरी. was the period of Renaissance. Joined hand in hand, and stethoscope, Lennox cylinder, symbol of physicians, was introduced. And stethoscope was a symbol of physician in those days. It was somewhere in 1834, and binaural stethoscope in 1885, so more than 50 years. Pyrometer was introduced in 1844 by Hutchinson, and X-rays, the accidental, truly seeing inside the body. It was not an intentional looking into that, but it was an accidental discovery which allowed a doctor to see inside the body of the patient. I'm sure some of you can identify this person. I'll give 2 seconds. Yes, you may be right. He is Theophile Hyacinthe Lennox, French physician who invented the stethoscope. It was, you know the anecdote of the incidents also. He faced a very embarrassing situation where he had to examine a lady, auscultate her. It was so embarrassing because she was too obese. In those days, auscultation was done the direct ear touching the chest wall, but it was very embarrassing for him. So he stuck with an idea. He remembered the childhood play of speaking through a thread, one end tied with one small stick, another small stick, touch it and speak on one side. So he could hear the other side. Similarly, what he thought is converted a paper into a roll and put one end on his chest, and then he auscultated through his ear. This was his first stethoscope made up of, I will use the word bamboo, because he was the skilled carving wooden flute. He was very good at carving the wooden flutes. He himself was a good musician, and with that skill, he produced the first stethoscope in those days. I'm going to identify him. He is Sir William Osler, the father of modern medicine. He was a master of art of clinical medicine. He was the first person to bring medical students out of lecture hall for bedside clinical training. Before that, all medicine was taught in lecture theaters, auditorium, or you can say museum and all. But it was he who brought them, made them realize the importance of clinical medicine, bedside medicine, and he taught them the art of practicing clinical medicine. He died 2 years after his son's death. And he died of lung abscess and emphysema, which was a complication of pneumonia. And in those days, it was an pandemic of influenza. Why I'm telling this, this X-ray was not taken for him before his death. He was diagnosed clinically, but he lost him with the same disease. Though just radiograph were available, but the awareness was not much, it was lacking. Only in 1945, the Royal Society concluded that radiographs are superior to stethoscope. Till that, they were all relying on stethoscope and its findings. Truly seeing inside the body, going ahead, how to see inside the body and get information of internal organ or functioning areas or functioning systems. If you want to know something in where there is no direct access, so we have to deploy some agencies. And these agencies should be capable of entering into the area where you want without disturbing the atmosphere there. And then they should start collecting the information and send it secretly to the people who want it. We call them spies. Similarly, to know something what's happening in the body without opening it, we have to deploy some of these agencies. Who are the agencies? They are, what will they do? They make you making use of these energies which can enter the body, interact with the tissues to provide the information of the internal organs or systems without any harmful effect. This is very important. So which are all those energies? The X-rays and conventional and contrast and CT. Gamma rays, using that, our radioisotope studies, sound, ultrasound, conventional Doppler, and so many other recent development in the ultrasound. Magnetic and radio frequency, MRI, and its wide varieties of application. Thermal energy and thermography, these are all varieties of energies used and sent into the body, permit them to interact with the tissue, they come out of the body, bring the information. But what is the major problem? None of these energies are within the perception of human being. Neither we can see the X-rays, gamma rays, sound, or hear the ultrasound. I see that none of them are, we are all beyond the perception of human being. From them, we are expecting an image to form, something observed, but that has been made possible by converting this invisible information into visible information and making use of display systems. Now, going through this evolution, I said that the first part I'll deal with the conventional radiology from nothing to DR system, that is digital radiographic system. Then later topics will be covered as and when required. At the end of each topic, a radiograph for the day will be given, and this is something you can keep on thinking and give your answers. About 3 years back, I was going to Sunday Herald and I saw this article, History on Our Plate. It was very interesting and made me still more convincing that history is very important. I never knew that cloth, which is here, was exchanged once upon a time with the equal amount of gold and the cloth. So that was history, how the importance of cloth, which I learned. Similarly, whatever that you see around has some or the other, some history behind. History of radiology, let me go through in the story form. I am of the opinion that past is not dead, but the one who does not know the past is dead. Knowing the past is growing stronger.
पुढील पुरस्कार आहे सर्वोत्कृष्ट नायक आणि विजेता आहे
उत्कृष्ट नायक.
ओके, यस, कुलकर्णी
स्वराज्याच्या संकटाचं गाढ अक्षर.
सिटिंग ऑन द पास्ट यू रिमेन वीक अँड ड्वार्फ. An interesting story is always there behind everything that we are experiencing now. Many of us are curious to know about it, but don't act. This is about the importance of history. X-ray was born on 8th November 1895 in this hall, in this room, in this laboratory at Bazaar.
Yes.
Sir, Mr. Wilhelm Conrad Röntgen was the father of X-ray. He was the son of a cloth merchant, was born in 1845 in Germany, and this was the place where he was born. His schooling was a problem and was expelled from the school. He was intelligent, but he was a nature lover. He used to go in the woods, move around all the hills and all, but he was equally good in studies too. And he used to roam in the open country and forest. He was expelled from the school for the reason. One day his teacher entered the classroom and saw a caricature drawn on the board. And immediately she asked, who has drawn it? As expected, nobody answered it. Wilhelm was sitting in the front bench. She made him stand and asked, tell me who has written this. He knew, but he didn't say. And the teacher said, you get out of the class. And from that expulsion day, his schooling was really a problem. He could not get entrance into best of the schools. And he was of this age, and this is the, okay. Letter from Wilhelm, at last he got entry into one of the institutes, and this was his entry into that college where he learned, finished early high school and college here. He was accepted to the Polytechnic Institute of Zurich. He studied mechanical engineering, and he graduated with a PhD from the University of Zurich. He met Anna Bertha Ludwig of Zurich. She was the daughter of the cafe owner there, and he married her in 1872. They never had any issues. Now comes on a day on a new kind of ray. which was discovered discovered in this university, Würzburg University, and this was the room where the X-ray was born, and he was Konrad Röntgen. A preliminary communication report was given on 1895, submitted to the Würzburg Physical Medical Society journal, and this was the first paper written on X-rays. And it was again a happening there. Everyone in those days were experimenting on the Coolidge tube and the cathode ray tubes. Similarly, the Konrad Röntgen was also experimenting on that. And one fine morning, he saw a plate was glowing on the ground. He knew that this plate on its own should not glow. It is neither self-luminescent nor it is reflecting, because there are no source of light to fall on that. He suspected something coming from his own experiment. He waved his hand between the set of experiment and the plate. He could see his own bone. He uttered a word, something mysterious, I don't know. Some peculiar rays are coming out from set of experiments. Yes, he said X rays because he didn't know. And that was how he could discover. You can see that one figure here. Now, this was the handwritten one which was given for publishing. And later it was printed in the Science Journal, kind of ray. Presentation was made in the auditorium because it has to be proved in front of knowledgeable persons in the university for it to be accepted and recognized. Presentation was made in the auditorium of Röntgen's own institute. Every seat in the auditorium was full. There was no seat for any additional people. After explaining the experiments and demonstrating various properties of X-ray, Röntgen invited Albert von Kolliker, who was a famous anatomist, to lend his hand or give a position for experimenting his X-ray. This was the hall where it is packed, and here Dr. Kolliker is sitting, his hand on the table, machine, first initial step of the X-ray machine, and here Konrad Röntgen demonstrating what he meant by a new kind of rays, posing his hand. This is the radio of the Kolliker. They'll show this image and ask, who's this radiograph? Immediately the answer comes, this is Anna Bertha, Mrs. Röntgen. No, it is not Anna Bertha's. It is the radiograph of the hand of von Kolliker, the anatomist, who volunteered himself to be present there for this experiment. And Kolliker was very happy, and he suggested and forced Röntgen to, Röntgen rays, why do you use X-rays? Put your name. And very, very calmly and with all humility, Röntgen denied using his name. This was the radiograph of Mrs. Bertha Röntgen, and it was almost a gift to her. When it was shown, she uttered a word, I have seen my death, looking at the bones of her hand. And these two. So the one which you see, a ring with a double ring here, is von Kolliker, and this is Röntgen. Real radiographs were taken of small animals like this. Röntgen, he himself used his name there, expressed his willingness to give the benefit of his experience to anyone wishing to carry on further research in medical institutions. He refused to out of the first 25 Nobel Prize winners in radiology, he was the first one to receive Nobel Prize in 1901. And this is Madame Curie and her discoveries regarding the isotope. And here comes the Godfrey Hounsfield for CT scan. But Röntgen was the first person to, he's a physics person, got Nobel Prize in the physics, but that is very commonly used for radiology medicine. December 10th, 1901, 5 years later, that is, Roentgen received his first ever Nobel Prize in physics. Terminal days of this great man, the great Nobel laureate, Roentgen, who died in poverty as a result of inflation, he shied away from public eye during his lifetime. For instance, he only ever held one single talk on his discovery of X-rays and declined the invitation to his Nobel Prize speeches. Nor did he have his valuable discovery patented, which probably accelerated its utilization in various fields, not only restricted to medical field, but varieties of fields. I'll come to that later. In the terminal days, that is, Roentgen, a few weeks before his death, he died of CA intestine, but nothing to do with the radiation because he hardly worked with the radiation. He thus discovered the X-rays. This was the place where he was laid down peacefully. And that was the story of Wilhelm Conrad Roentgen, the Nobel Prize winner. Because of him, who has shown some energy which has memorial stone inside the Roentgen memorial site. These first day stamps were released, a new kind of ray. Using this, lot of X-ray studios are opened, not by doctors, but by laymen. They started opening X-ray studios. Come and see what your wife has kept in your purse without opening it. Or would you like to see something where the nail pricks your shoes? Come and see. Like that, it was a play or just toy, like it was misused. It was more popular as an entertaining toy. And this was some of the images which they used to draw, considering the farmer and they drew the Roentgen like that. So these are some of the amusing part of the X-rays, and later they really misused it with the grave results. In shoe mart, to fit the shoes correctly to the foot, they made use of X-rays. They used to keep the foot here, X-rays are passed from here, and see whether it is fitting correctly or not. All the bones are okay, rightly fitting or not. And this is another view. He used to stand with the hand grip. He used to stand there and look for the positioning of it. And again, similarly, all the nails are properly placed or not. So it was used, one of the examples I said was in the shoe rack, the shoe company or shoe shop. And the X-ray machines in those days were very crude, hanging wires, a bare bulb. Most of the department of X-rays were all in the cellar, mainly because they involve a lot of electrical gadgets. And that's how initially diploma in medical radiology and electrology, DMRE in Maharashtra, was given. It was not DMRD because even X-rays and equipments were included into physiotherapy equipment, ECG equipment, all related to electrical, and they are, most of them used to be cellular. X-ray studios are open. Prolonged exposure, hours together they used to expose. You can imagine how much radiation they would have. Only two densities could be seen. What is that? Air and bone. Nothing else, no more details of the anatomical structure. Fluoroscopy was preferred to radiographs because initially only fluoroscopy was seen, because they could not see too many structure. They could see beating heart, they could see moving diaphragm. They said lungs are clear, heart is beating and diaphragm moving. That's all the interpretation. When the radiographs came, lot of anatomical structure they have to pour in, they have to read, refresh their anatomy. And they said it is fine, only fluoroscopy is preferred. That is because of the ignorance. And these X-ray machines replaced the crepitus for fracture. Initial clinical diagnosis of fracture by only through crepitus, but X-rays, they could see the site of fracture. Chest diseases, regarding that, 1945, Royal Society concluded that radiographs are superior to stethoscope. It took so many years, even after the birth of X-ray, it took many years to convince that it is better than stethoscope, some of it. These are all some of the initial X-ray machine. This was the portable X-ray machine. I remember one was in a port of the Wanless Hospital. I have got so many sweet memories of the growing and evolving radiology department in Wanless Hospital. And this was one of it which I could remember. It was very much there. And here you can see a fully dressed lady. And you can call him a radiologist rather than radiologist, the physician, the handheld fluoroscopic unit. And this is the X-ray tube, razor passing through. He's looking into beating heart. There's no protection, no more gadgets. And he could see hours together beating heart for clear view. And these are all the hanging radiographs which are for advertisement. This is the World War II time. You can see it is a radiologist or a physician. Look at this X-ray tube passing through, and it has got a fluoroscopic device. He can see the moving structures. And again, I remember in Wanless Hospital, a very big machine was there with a huge knob. They are all older machines of the X-ray units. Now it is a quiz for you. I say this is a high tension cable, and this is the X-ray tube. And here the patient lying on an inclined table. Can you tell me where is the radiologist? Other than that, the physician is below here with a fluoroscopic, handheld fluoroscopy, sitting on a chair, looking at the structures in the chest. One common thing you find in all these X-ray machines is most of all these X-ray machines are vertical. Till the horizontal X-ray machine came, they could not do very many more. And this one is the mass miniature radiography, MMR. And you can see full completely dressed. This is some improvisation is there. He has undressed and taking for fluoroscopy. And here he's explaining he has got a dextrocardia and heart beating. And she is curiously looking into all these onlookers. And he is holding that patient not to move. These are the X-ray machine, portable, if not portable, the mobile X-ray machine. During World War, they are used. And they're the first horizontal X-ray tube, X-ray machine. Later, the concept of not the ease of doing very minimal as possible. Now, till now, you went through the series of X-ray machines and the growth of X-rays and its utility in those days with those crude machines. But none of those people were aware of the hidden danger. Almost all of them suffered with this hidden danger. Most of them, they used these X-ray machines for toy purposes, initial amusing purposes, or you can say some fair. Most of them all died of leukemia because of radiation injury, which they did not realize at that point. And you have the hidden danger. The initial X-ray machines needed patients to sit still for well over an hour or so. They have to stay still for more than an hour or so. They are doused, they are burned with 1500 doses on them to see some in the body. 1500 times the amount of radiation as today's machines. And the pictures are fuzzy at best. But even then, they have those fuzzy machines. Radiation burning to the patient, radiation dose to the patient because of very crude, low-capable machines. Once the radiation started seeing, people started seeing the radiation injury visible. That was an incident happened. A boy was shot with a bullet in his head. Doctors attended, that is mainly Daniel and Ben. They decided to undertake an experiment using X-ray machine or X-ray tube. To experiment over the patient, they experimented on their own. So Daniel held the fluoroscopy plate on the side of the doodle's head, and he passed X-rays through that for 1 hour. And later, after 21 days, that area was devoid of hair, which approximately 2 inch area where the X-rays were exposed, the area was exposed, that was alopecia and devoid of hair. The first visible radiation injury. First victim of radiation martyr, she was a nun. She used to adjust or hold the children for, can say, immobile, and they should not move steadily for radiographic purposes. Thousands of children she used to hold, and she developed aggressive cancer in her hand, and later she died of the same. The second victim was Clarence Darrow. He was the first martyr in the United States, X-ray martyr in the United States. He was a glass blower. He used to, after the manufacturing the glass, even for X-ray tube, there was a glass manufacturer. He used to test them by exposing inside and using his hand for fluoroscopy. He too developed aggressive cancer in his hands. Despite the progressive amputation of his fingers, hands, arms, then even his scapula, the cancer still spread. His period of illness and death is reported to have been agonizing. You can imagine how much suffering he might have had. Because he, while using, he was not knowing that they are so dangerous. So this is a hidden danger, and these people suffered a lot. Mehran Kasebin, by that time, was already knowing that they are dangerous, but it was too late when he realized it. But the physician, he suffered the same fate as earlier people, exposure to rays in his laboratory. What he did was he never subjected himself for surgery for amputation of the areas affected. He continued to suffer the pain and went on recording all his suffering in black and white of his disease for the posterity. And this was what he could offer to the mankind and for their safety. It was the final gift he was empowered to give to the mankind. Kasebin, you can see, he was the director of Rundgren Laboratory in Philadelphia. He performed X-ray examination more than thousands and thousands. And he was the person, and this was what he suffered. But he made a note of all that and published it, people to realize that don't have a casual approach to these X-rays having hidden injuries. This is how they used to do initially. This was a handheld fluoroscopic, and this is the fluoroscopic screen. On this will be the X-ray tube. I used to test whether I can see my fingers correctly or not. Hold the fluoroscopic device in right hand and test the left hand. You see all that, almost all of them are doing the same thing, and most of them all develop squamous cell carcinoma of the left hand, and some of them right hand, both of them, those who used to hold the patient, both the hands. This is all the mutilation. Hand of physician exposed small doses of X-rays for 15 years, he developed skin cancer. These are not true diagnostic X-rays, these are deep X-ray burns, but X-rays were harmful. The radiation injury, some they took it lightly and started writing cartoons, and this is how. And he was a boy, a girl, and he wanted to protect her from X-ray by raising the umbrella. You can see what you can expect to see here. When people realized that it was very harmful, they started dressing themselves with all like armor sheet, going for a battlefield. Everywhere, lead apron, lead gloves, lead headgear and everything. And this is later the concept of radiation protection came, rules and regulations for radiation protection they had to follow, and testing all the X-ray machine for leaking X-rays. Many, many of the restrictions, or you can say regulations, came to use the X-rays. A monument to the radiation martyrs. 150 names inscribed on this stele, and it is the Germany, and all those names are put on this. Here I remember when I used to take class for undergraduates, and when I take them into fluoroscopic room or barium and all, I used to ask them to close their eyes, 10 minutes, pray for those who died for radiology. Then I used to tell the history, how it was harmful. I remember very clearly. Now this is how the hidden danger and martyrs of radiology during its evolution, which we should pay great respect and keep on remembering them and protect ourselves and also our progeny from radiation hazards. Some first radiographs, the first radiograph for foreign body location, first case of osteomyelitis, radiograph, and septic arthritis of the elbow, radiograph. Now here comes, we should be aware of the past and learn from it. Once we're aware, then not to forget what we learned. Respect radiation. Don't indulge into radiation when not required. Be very stingy and meticulous in using it. Provide still better and safer future for progeny. This tree in our campus reminds me every happy summer, whenever it blooms out like this, making us forget the past dried leaves and all, keeping hope that every time it blooms out. And similarly here, let the present grow stronger on the backdrop of the past. Now, we should leave a safer world for our children, especially I'm talking related to radiation injury. Now, experiencing the hidden danger, radiation hazards were visible. Dr. Mayo, Bruce, and all the list of the doctors which I already conveyed died of radiation injuries, and memorial was home. They kept no protection around X-ray tubes. Test on operator's own hand, fluorescent screen, fracture education, reduction under fluoro, direct fluoroscopy. You can imagine how long they used to expose their hands. Fluorescent screens are very, very, you have to really peep through it to see some additional, some images. So low strength X-ray units and the fluoroscopy. Poor quality in prolonged exposures, all have led to exposing the hidden danger. The need of the hour was improvising image quality, minimizing radiation exposure, time and dose, radiation production concept and the devices. So need of the hour, refinement of equipment. Improvised tubes entered, modified, upgraded rectification transformers, focal spots image intensification, improved contrast media, plates and films are improved. Here I give an example that initially the radiographic films were highly inflammable and they are all stored in the cellar. Once they got fire and 129 people died with this fire accident. So suddenly change these films with non-inflammable base. Radiation production devices were introduced. Now, equipment which can provide, what is required, need of the hour is, we need equipment which can provide consistent best image quality with more anatomical details, least radiation to the patients, least radiation to radiation workers, human errors should be least and almost nil, most economical it should be, faster results, better image information storage and retrieval, what is called RIS system, that is radiology information system. Yes, in this direction, some initial steps are taken. And I'll show you one more image. Rather than the image, I'll show you one name. Most of you heard the word Bucky in radiology. I don't think any of you have not heard the word radiology, Bucky. Whenever poor X-ray quality, your senior will say, go and get Bucky done. For this, you need Bucky. What is the Bucky? What is this Bucky? But you have definitely heard the Bucky in radiology. He was a radiologist who invented a device, Bucky diaphragm. It is to reduce the blur of X-ray images, but it caused grid lines to appear on the films.
पैठणीचा खेळ खेळ मनसोक्त खेळ आहे. कारण हा फक्त खेळ नाहीये, ही स्पर्धा नाहीये, तर आनंद आहे. खरंच बरं वाटलं या सगळ्यांचं प्रेम घेऊन निघाले आणि इथे आले. प्रेमच प्रेमाचे ओझ होतच ना, म्हणून यायला उशीर झाला.
अरे भाऊजी, जोपर्यंत तुम्हाला भेटा म्हणताय तोपर्यंत एक तुम्हाला सांगतो बरं का, की आमची झी मराठीची कॉलनी ना, म्हणजे इथे सगळे तुम्ही बघताय घर नंबर आहेत, आणि आम्ही सगळे कुटुंबीय आहोत बरं का. मी मगाशी अंताक्षरीचा खेळ असा काय रंगला होता की विचारू नका, तुम्ही असायला पाहिजे होता. मला असं वाटतं एखाद्या गाण्याला ना तुम्ही असं पळत जाऊन मस्तपैकी बच्चनजींच्या स्टाईलमध्ये इंटरव्ह्यू लाईव्ह घेतले असते. एक परफॉर्मन्स आम्ही पाहिलं त्याच्यात साधारण तुमच्यासारखंच कोणीतरी होतं बच्चनजींचा रोल करणार, पण आम्हाला तुम्ही तिथे हवे होता. आणि हा आज विशेष म्हणजे बरं का, आमची ही जी कॉलनी आहे ना, तर आता पैठणीचा खेळ कुणी खेळायचा म्हणून त्या आमची एक छोटीशी बैठक झाली सगळ्यांची मिळून, तर त्याच्यामध्ये सोनं टाकलं, आमचं नाव निघालं, तर मी आणि माझी बायको म्हणजे आम्ही खरं तर आज पैठणीचा खेळ खेळणार आहोत, फक्त आमचा मुलगा येईल थोड्या वेळात त्याची वाट बघतोय, तर जरा तुमचा फेटा बांधून होईपर्यंत थोडी जरा कळ करा प्लीज. आला आला इकडे इकडे
आला आला धावत आला पोरग माझा आलो.
अरे हा पोर त्याच्या मूळ वयात आला. वा वा वा, जोरदार टॅलेंट आहे त्याच्यासाठी झाला पाहिजे. सेम टीचर आहे, सेम टीचर आहे. हा मी काय म्हणतो, मी काय आणलं की सांग
सगळ्यांना,
रिमोट आणलाय. सो आता हा रिमोट घेऊन आम्ही सगळे तर पाहणार आहोत झी मराठी. तुम्ही आपल्या घरी पाहत राहा झी मराठी. पण
चला मग बोलव ना लवकर. मामाजी
आमचे माझे बाबा रोज 6:30 ते 10:30 न चुकता झी मराठी बघता
बरोबर आहे. एक वेळ संध्या चुकेल कार्यक्रम झी मराठीचा एकही चुकवत नाही.
चला तर या रिमोटने आम्ही सगळे मिळून पाहणार आहोत झी मराठी. मी मराठी, झी मराठी.
हॅलो
मशीनला येत नाही का ठीक आहे
हॅलो
हॅलो कॅन यू हिअर मी डॉक्टर सोलटूर नमस्कार डॉक्टर एस वी आय एंटर
शेअर शेअर स्क्रीन
डॉक्टर एस वी यू हॅव डिसेबल्ड
स्क्रीन शेअरिंग
स्क्रीन शेअरिंग टू बी डन
हॅलो
हॅलो
हा
नमस्कार रे
नमस्कार एक बंद ऐकतो
अदो लॉग आउट इदो सर टाइम मुगीतदो एस वी मत डूइंग नाउ डॉक्टर एस वी इज डूइंग Dr. S.V.
ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಅವ ಕುಡ್ಕಣ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದಾನೆ ನಿಮ್ದು ಮುಗಿರ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಲೆಕ್ಚರ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್
ಹತ್ತು ನಿಮಿಷ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಸರ್ ಹಲೋ ಎಸ್ ವಿ Can you see all of you my screen there?
Yes, oh. Yes.
Yeah.
Screen, presentation.
Presentation, can you see? No.
Yes, you can start.
Probably there is internet disconnection with SV Kulkarni.
Mm.
We can see your face, sir, but the presentation is not seen.
Now I will try again. Can you see now?
Yeah. Now, sir, presentation also is being seen.
Yes.
Okay, I'll go ahead then. If the
yeah. Yes, sir.
I was just telling about the Bucky. So he is a radiologist Bucky who introduced the Bucky diaphragm and the reason why it was necessary. And later, because the grid lines were seen, it was Dr. Hollis Potter made it move and it's called a moving grid. And later it was called Potter-Bucky diaphragm. So he was Dr. Bucky. And he was Dr. Potter, and that is what you see, a Bucky diaphragm or moving Bucky grid below the underneath the table, and that is to improve the quality of the image. Bucky meanwhile was very close friend of Einstein also. He was there with Einstein during at the time of his death. Now chest radiographs utility away from the casual utility in disease purpose, the tuberculosis mobile and MMR mass miniature radiographies were introduced. This is how the people used to gather and survey used to be done. Fluoro radiography, where the patient moving structures were seen during deep inspiration, diaphragm, expiration, diaphragm. They used to draw the markings on the plate and beating heart. This is during expiration, the heart size has increased and diaphragms have gone more. And here is the opacity. This they used to draw. During our DMRD, we used to draw this on a paper looking at the fluoroscopy. Dr. Soltur might have seen, Dr. Thomas. It used to be very common for all of us. This was the initial conventional radiography with a very poor quality. I can hardly see any blood vessels. And this was a little more improvised conventional radiography. I can see the endons better, the clear lung fields, the branches are the arteries and the cardiac margin is a sharper cardiac margin than previous. Now here you can see digital radiography, definitely far improved image quality, very sharp margins you can see, and the endons and the hilea are far, even the bone details are seen better. Now I can see here the inferior pulmonary vein, or we can say the lower pulmonary vein, which is draining into left atrium. So this is the clarity of direct digital radiography or DR system, which was not possible. I remember the teachings initially when I used to tell this, always see behind the diaphragm, look behind the heart, look, see through the heart. Now with the DR system, I have to modify my teaching. It is already seen, appreciated. You should know the anatomy more now because more structures are seen. So digital radiography, this is the advantage. And this was the conventional dental radiography. These are all the digital dental radiographies. You can see very clearly the lamina dura and all the details and structures here. The digital imaging, X-ray image is digitalized. Primary acquisition of a digitalized image, one type, that is direct. Acquired conventional image, that is computerized radiography. Definitely DR system is better, but it is more costlier. All that needs is a computer, post-processing of the image is possible, filmless department you can create, real-time imaging in endodontic therapy can be done, is a very costly one. Advantage of digital radiography, you can see immediate observation of the image. High grayscale, wide variety of grayscale, so you can appreciate image quality and structures very clearly. Ability to enhance images, post-processing you can do. You can see only the bones or the structure, the vessels. You can alter the contrast and the brightness. Data storage is very easy because all the images are digitalized. So storing in the computer section is very easy. Once you store, you can retrieve them also. You can send them also. All that is what is being done in the RIS system, radiology information system. Elimination of processing chemicals and find their inherent problem. I remember again, Mission Hospital. Lot of artifacts used to come, kissing artifact, crinkle artifact, all those static artifact. I think some of the senior students now remember, and all those are eliminated now. RIS, that is Radiology Information System, communication with other practitioners, you can do it, sending the images on soft copies. Less radiation, recently we had a DR system. Probably if you give about 16 MAS for a chest radiograph of a moderately built person, here we give 2 to 3 MAS. That is the amount of radiation you are reducing to the patient with a very good quality of image. So loss of conventional film is to be very common. Again, I remember Manlius Hospital, Rastya was in charge of the store of the all the recording system. It is Rastya's department, X-ray speaking, he was talking, I remember that. And all people used to come, I want the old X-rays, used to go and search. That problem of losing conventional film is not there. Everything is stored as soft copies and they can be easily retrieved. Highly efficient because manpower is reduced, time factor is reduced, and darkroom techniques is no more present. Now there are some inherent drawbacks of conventional plain film study. Inherent major problem of conventional is image continue to be overlapping. That is, a three-dimensional structure is compressed into two-dimensional represented as an image. Naturally, there will be a lot of overlapping of the anatomical structures. You have to analyze independently, individually to appreciate one structure, and that is a lot of skill. Lack of tissue differentiation. You can only differentiate soft tissues, bone, and of course, air is always there, but not beyond that. That is, lack of tissue differentiation. Then comes the contrast radiography. To enhance the contrast difference between two structures, they started artificially enhancing those by adding the contrast media. GI radiology by barium, vascular study, neuroimaging, bronchial, that bronchograms, urological study, a list of contrast studies are there. The basic requirement contrast study is to enhance the contrast difference between two similar structures or the anatomical structure so that the one which is enhanced is studied in detail. Now, overlapping problem was solved by body section radiography. Now, this image is very difficult to appreciate. Some people are overlapping, somebody sitting on the head. You want to know who is playing at what plane. So that was an overlapping, and you have to analyze. And this here, the two, you can see sectional imaging at various levels, and you can appreciate those separate. Classical tomography is no more used, and it's used to, its principle was different. Image used to be very bad, and still people used to be happy because nothing else was available. And this you can see one of those mid-layer image due to classical tomography. Nowadays you've got excellent CT scan with sub-millimeter recon images showing all the ossicles and the details of the internal ear also. Just to little go away from the conventional presentation now, pareidolia is something, an art of imagining images in the cloud. The person who can imagine the images in the cloud can become the best radiologist. So they say so. Newer specialized equipment started coming, CT, IITV, digital radiography, DSA, CINE. Meanwhile, ultrasound, MRI, PET, SPECT, nano imaging. These are all the added specialized equipment. So the conventional old time initial angiographies. Now, a few points I have to say. During this process, I remember the bird dodo. Dodo was, nowadays extinct species, was plenty present. It was present in Mauritius, and it was responsible to keep the natural cycle and the ambience. It used to survive on particular fruit of a tree, and the excreta of this dodo used to give out that seed, and it used to come out. Nothing else can dissolve the surface of the seed except when it eats, when it's thrown out, then no excreta, then only the tree will grow. So the because of the island, initial people who invaded the island felt this peculiar, hapless, non-flying bird. They started killing it and eating it, and the cycle, whole cycle was destroyed. This is called active extinction. This is what happened in some of the our own imaging methods also. The list you see here, pneumoencephalo, pneumoventriclo, myodimilo, all these are extinct now. Many of the seniors have done many of these, like again, all seniors who are present there, and there are no more being done. Splenocortography, translumbar aortography used to be a great thing in mirrors. Pharmacoangiography after coming from Chandigarh. IV cholangiography using PTC needle, OCG. Oh, oral colonoscopy used to be a very big feat for 3 days. Give preparation, give plain radiograph, give contrast, wait for 24. No more they are there. Muscopan and barium swallow, hypodip donography, all these are extinct nowadays. It is not one way to the active extinction because of the presence of availability of the better imaging modalities. Automatically they have gone back and they have taken a back seat. Now there is something here. Can junior, one of your juniors say or write and give it to the convener, what is this investigation? It was a ventriculogram, both air and myodial ventriculography. And all these are extinct now. You can see the list of all these big lists. I think now, literally I have done these in the Mission Hospital. This also I have done, making the patient sit and inject till he complains of headache. We used to inject air into the lumbar puncture, through the lumbar puncture. This is pneumocysternography. Both cisterns and ventricles are seen. This Dr. Tata used to come and do, come on, put it there. What are you doing? I used to say, blind, put it, used to, blood used to out, inject dye, connect it to cylinder. Oh, all very crude. I don't know how many damage we have done to all these patients. Blindly hitting the carotids. I don't know how many brittle plexus I have damaged. Horrible experiences. They are not available. They are dead. They are all extinct now. Progressive imaging technology has come now. You can see least invasive, maximum information, excellent anatomical details. Again, you can see the tactographies. You can trace the white matters. You can do functional MRI, stimulating particular area of the functioning body, allowing you to have different chemical component as compared to neighboring, which will be shown as a coded area because the chemicals are different as compared to health. A functional image, chemical analysis of the structure also can be done. Progressive imaging continued. You can see same thing, ultrasound, nano imaging. These are all the nano images. This is the mouse cerebral vessel, mouse pulmonary vessels, rabbit kidney, human lung slice, nano CT. All these are going on still. Champions who have escaped the onslaught. Chest radiograph remains the best. It cannot die. It cannot be extinct. It is equally important, equally used, and gaining more and more importance, and growing younger and younger. Plain radiograph of the abdomen, not escape. It has escaped the onslaught. Upper GI contrast studies, colon and rectum are gradually going out. Small bowel imaging, still some places there. Bone radiography, they cannot die. They continue to remain. And this is how all these were escaped, giving a naughty smile at the recent developments in the imaging modality. Carry home message. Knowledge of evolution of medical imaging is essential in changing our outlook. Be consciously aware of the sacrifices done by pioneering the process of evolution of medical imaging. Respect radiation. Be judicious, stingy in using it. Latest need not be the best. I repeat, latest need not be the best. Not to neglect simpler, older imaging methods. Patient's well-being is most important. We treat the patient, not the images. Nothing is more enjoyable than the beauty of the nature. Continue to enjoy the beauty of the nature. Thank you very much for your patient lady. And now comes a case of the day. 45 years, male, admitted with CVA, cerebrovascular accident. This is the first radiograph taken, portable. I'll give 30 seconds to go through any positive findings. Obvious positive finding, apart from, because this lucency is because of rotation. And this increase, yes, anybody?
Backyard.
Okay, any other? There is a soft tissue density with a very sharp margin. Posterior ribs are very clear. Aortic knuckle is still seen, so it is not in the posterior mediastinum. Medial margin is ill-defined, but I can trace this up to here. So if I complete the circle, it is not a mediastinum. It is in the outside the mediastinum and sharp margin. So many differential diagnoses a radiology student can give, aneurysm of the subclavian artery, or just Sertus said ganglion, or these neurogenic tumors, or cysts sometimes. But this is the radiograph, and I'll come out to the answer now. Radiograph was repeated after 24 hours. The shadow had disappeared. It was nothing but a lemon which was tied by the patient in the neck. And this is a lemon. This is the CT of lemon which I kept it there. So never be carried away by some of these things. Analyze them, reason them, and then come out. And if you want, patient is always there. Why can't you go and talk to it? Thank you very much for patient listening. Thank you all. This is from my side. Is there any questions?
Why do you know?
Otherwise, I'll read and let you know, and I'll learn still more by discussing.
Dr. Joshi.
Yes, please.
Why the X-ray which you showed? There's a hyperlucent lung on the left side.
Yes, you are very right. I'm very happy you raised that. Whenever patient rotates, the side on which he rotates is relatively looser than the other side. It is a technical problem. Underlying to explain the lucency, there are no signs of hyperinflation, there are no signs of vascular oligemia, there are no signs of compensatory emphysema to show a loss of function somewhere else. So it is a technical, and apparently it looks dark, but it is not.
But in that case, there will be the movement or the curvature of the spine will be different.
No. See, patient, you can see the scapula, the clavicle have gone up. I'll show you that again. They have gone up one side like this, and whole rotate, only shoulders may rotate. He may not rotate. And usually these radiographs, if you carefully see, there may be little spine rotation too. A little rotation is enough to call distortion and the image densities.
Yes, doctor. Thank you, sir.
I can see you now. I was missing you. Thank you.
Dr. G.S. Kulkarni, Dr. Thomas. So we are so happy that you are there.
Nice to see you all.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Can you hear me?
Nostalgic memory, Dr. C. Thomas, I share one. He came running with his team. Immediately said, Dr. Roshi, I'm very sorry. Sir, what happened? That patient should not have been sent for imaging here. It was a case of thigh injury. And hurriedly, I sent the patient. He went into hypotension. We didn't take the x-rays because it was a fat embolism. He came and surveyed, told me he should not have been sent. Such a nice clinician. Even now his teachers remember him. All those teachers, all those students, yes, taught by Thomas. Similarly, Dr. Sartur. Oh, Sartur's name as a guru, everywhere it is there. And I was so lucky enough to be associated with such a great people and such a nice student. I had an opportunity of learning from all the students who were posted to radiology for 6 months during their PG career. That has added a lot of clinical things to me. I learned many things from Gopya also. I learned many things from Ajay Brahmanalkar. They used to discuss VNVS, take anybody. Everyone has taught me. What I'm here today is all the contribution from all of you. I'm very lucky to see you all here and compliment Dr. S.V. Kulkarni. I will not call Gopya.
Okay. It's okay, sir. It's okay. It's all family matter.
Dr. Joshi, yeah. I just want to say, after you joined the Wanless Hospital,
yes, sir.
The level of radio diagnosis shot up 100%. 100%.
Oh, great.
And great. You know, it was before Joshi and after Joshi. There was a world of difference. All of us clinicians, we learned a lot thanks to you.
God
and,
is very
you know, you were such an excellent radiologist. I just want to take this opportunity to say thank you very much from all of us, clinicians and the students and the residents. You taught us a lot. Thank you, Dr. Joshi. God bless you.
Thanks of you. God is very kind to me. I never knew that I was there.
Can I talk?
Yes, please, sir.
Dr. Joshi, you have given us a very nice history of Rodgen and his life story. Very nice, very interesting. You made it. And then I reminded, I had fracture of the tibia in 1952. That time, only reduced my fracture with that screen that you showed us. Cone-like. That time the only screen was available. And then he reduced it. I remember now. It's very interesting. Your talk is very interesting. Very made us, you know, the history and very interesting. Thank you. You know, I wanted to just see, peep in and go. But talk made me to sit till the end.
Thank you.
And Thomas, where are you now?
I'm in Florida. Florida, USA.
USA, you are in USA. Yeah, nice to see your face. You are as
good. Long time.
long time I'm seeing you.
He was invasive radiologist. He was all in one. So namaskar. Okay.
Sir. Dr. Sartur, nice to see you, Dr. Sartur.
Sir has taken great efforts to join today's meeting. You know, I used to call him three times a day. demo meeting, all other things.
I want to share some diagnostic problem which we had.
Yes.
See, Dr. Mazzarello, people must be knowing.
Okay.
He was a gynecologist.
Uh-huh.
See, he went to Bombay for a backache, and he was investigated, was diagnosed as a meningitis. Meningitis. He did not improve, and he started getting weakness and weakness. His daughter was a is also pediatrician. She came to me. The history gave last few months. He's unable to get up from the bed. So indicating proximal muscle weakness. So then we did the radiology. Remember, he had a barium. It was a big tumor in the stomach, almost occupying the stomach. So it was a proximal myopathy, secondary to the thing.
Paramalignant manifestation. So it was a CA fundic region, more of it, I remember, extending into lesser curvature. The palpable mass. So usually I tell them that CA stomach is the one which is very stealthily enters, and if it is uncontrolled anemia, it will be the stomach and colon. They will not manifest except for anemia. It is a paramalignant manifestation. Thank you for finding.
Thank you, sir. Amongst all these 25, we have got a star speaker for the next meeting also. Incidentally, our institution, Niraj Medical College, Government Medical College, is celebrating its 58th birthday on 31st of July. So, Soltu sir has to be one of the speakers, and there is going to be one more galaxy person who is going to address our day-to-day and for problems in a very, very simpler, nicer, and very friendly way. Now, can I ask everybody to unmute themselves and speak few words? Start from Vijay Desai. Vijay Desai is in Belgaum, and he is one of the person who has got a license to do testing for COVID vaccine. Vijay, please go ahead.
Thank you. Good evening, everybody. Nice to see you, see Dr. Dr. Sotris, Dr. Kujias, after a long time. Thank you so much. And this was really a very nice presentation, by, as usual, by Dr. Joshi, sir. We learned a lot of things during our stint at the radiology department. And I'm very thankful to you, Joshi, sir, for the same. Thank you.
Dr. Huli, can you unmute yourself? Dr. Vijay Kumar.
Yeah. It was a nice interaction to see all our professors, all the elders. It was a very nice interaction.
We are also seeing you after 42 years on screen.
Yeah.
Except for your photographs.
Yeah.
He is our classmate. Exactly where you are working right now?
Right now I'm working in Sindhanur. That is in Raichur district.
Okay. Yeah.
Raichur. It is exactly between Ballari and Raichur, halfway.
So thank you for joining. Invite more friends next time. BJ Shinde. BJ.
Yes. Good evening, everybody. The great teachers of our time, Dr. Soltu sir, Dr. Thomas sir. Thomas sir is actually, you may not be remembering me, actually, I'm his official student. I was transferred to him from Civil Hospital. He has signed my thesis, but Thomas may not be recollecting me. Anyway, I'm his official student. I still recollect Shamsundar Joshi sir, actually, when during undergraduate time, taking our clinics, and we're literally fascinated by the talk, the ways to speak, and the teachers regarding the normal x-rays and some procedures. I'm seeing you, Soltu sir, after a very, very long time. I hear a lot about you from SV, because see, I am from a batch of Dr. SV Kulkarni, 1974 batch.
Okay.
Yes, sir. And we got admitted in 1974. We passed together, and we that time we created a history. We only 6 candidates were the freshers. They only could get through. All repeaters were they were left behind. Only the freshers, we 6 were the only we could get through. At the very first attempt. So I'm one of them. A.N. Kulkarni, myself, Satish Paranjpe, Bhide, and Dr. S.P. Kulkarni. But it was very nice to see all. Nice to see everybody. Actually, we used to go to Dr. G.S. Kulkarni sir for some orthopedics clinics in his own hospital. And he used to teach us his own students. Thank you very much, sir. Actually, I am extremely happy to see you. And we hear a lot about you from other patients. Actually, I'm basically from Sangli district only, but I'm practicing in Raigarh. I'm basically from a place called Vita. But actually, passing my MD, actually, government caught me and posted me here in Raigarh district in Mangaon. This is a bonded candidate for 2 years, but actually, somehow I couldn't pull on for 2 years. I just resigned within 14 months only because I am not made for a government job. So, immediately I started my own setup.
He was kidnapped by Antule, the prime minister, chief minister at that time.
Yes.
Sir, Dr. GSK, please. Dr. G.S. Kulkarni, sir.
Yes, what is it?
You are going to, you and Dr. Soltor are going to speak last now. So I'm giving chance to every student. Neelam is a pediatrician.
Actually, good evening all. I am pediatrician, but because of the Gopya Kulkarni's initiative, I could see the medicine stalwarts like Dr. Sotu, Dr. Thomas, then Dr. Joshi. I did not recognize him in the first meeting, but I feel very ashamed of that. But I was not expecting sir to join. I was expecting all PG students to join. So I was recognizing who is he. But J.S. Kulkarni, I always remember because of our clinical meetings. So I am odd in that because I am pediatrician, but I have undergone teaching it with all of your stalwarts. So it's very nice. So I join every Sunday, I join this meeting to see my teachers. Neelam there, Phansarkar, every pediatrics. Hello.
Sanjay Korde. Sanjay, can you unmute? Sanjay, please. Sanjay, mothyane bol. Hello.
Hello.
Sanjay, your audio is not clear.
Hello.
You use your microphone.
Hello. Can you listen now?
Yes, we can hear you clearly.
I'm from Satara. Hello.
Please.
I'm from Satara. Today I'm fortunate to see all of you after a long time. And all my teachers are here. I'm 1976 batch. I'm practicing Satara, practicing with a multi-specialty as one of the director of Sanjeevan Hospital at Satara. And this is today's my first meeting to join you. It is very great pleasure to join you.
You will get addicted. Don't worry.
Yes.
Sorry. I joined late.
It's all right.
But I am very much fan of all these teachers. Joshi sir, I remember all radiology, undergrad and postgrad. Also, I seen him at Krishna Hospital also. So lot of learning. Thank you very much.
Yes. Thank you, Sanjay.
Yeah.
Anjali, can you say some? You want to say something? Where are you? From which batch?
Good evening, everybody, sir. I'm from past MD in 1990, actually. And I'm Dr. C. Thomas, sir, student, and I work with Dr. Sotur also in his private clinic. I used to work with him. And I worked with Dr. S.K. Joshi also in Disha Diagnostic Center in Belgium. I'm practicing in Belgium. So... the opportunity to work for 2 years with Dr. Joshi. He taught me sonography. Even though I'm a physician, it is very, very useful to me in my practice, this sonography and echocardiography. Thank you very much, and I'm very happy to be here.
Thank you, Jayant Rao Gayakwad, across the ocean. Jayant, bol.
Hello, namaste.
It's 9 o'clock.
Mauritius.
Yeah.
Then, yeah, Avaz, volume not good. Use your mouth. Yes.
Yes, yes. Barobbar 40 varshani Sotur sir ana pahile. GS Kulkarni na pan 40 varshani ta pahile. जीएस कुलकर्णींचं खूप मोठं अट्रॅक्शन असायचं. संध्याकाळच्या क्लिनिकसाठी आम्ही जायचो त्याच्याबरोबर, आम्हाला आणि थोडं प्रसाद मिळायचा, ओशोची फिलॉसॉफी पण ऐकायला मिळायची त्या काळात. खूप क्लिनिक ती अतिशय उत्साहान आम्ही सगळेजण जायचो आणि खूप मजा यायची. आणि सोटू सरांचं तर भयंकर अट्रॅक्शन असायचं, जे म्हणून त्यांचे लेक्चर्स असतील क्लिनिक ती सगळी अटेंड करायचो. थॉमस सरांची क्लिनिक अंडर ग्रॅज्युएटला खूपच महत्वाची ठरली आणि त्यावेळी क्लिनिक चालायची म्हणजे जवळजवळ बऱ्याच वेळा आमचं जेवण पण त्याच्यामध्ये जायचं, दोन दोन वाजायचं आणि एकला संपायला पाहिजे होतं एक ते दोन. अनेक वेळा पीएसएमसी लेक्चरला आम्ही उशिरा गेलो होतो किंवा वर्गाबाहेर हाकलले गेलो होतो क्लिनिकला उशीर. खूप आनंद वाटला. सध्या मी 74 बॅचचा MBBS ऍडमिशन आणि मी MD पीडियाट्रिक्स केलं डॉक्टर करमरकर सरांच्याकडे. आणि आत्ता सध्या मॉरिशसमध्ये मी एका MBBS कॉलेजमध्ये पीडियाट्रिक्सचा हेड ऑफ द डिपार्टमेंट म्हणून काम करतो.
संजू साने, साने
हॅलो.
येस आवाज.
आय बिलॉंग टू 74 बॅच अँड आय पे माय रिस्पेक्ट टू ऑल माय टीचर्स. And we have been extremely blessed to have teachers like you, and we are extremely grateful to you for all the teaching and knowledge you imparted to us. It is a very happy moment to see you all after so many years, and we are extremely grateful to you, all the teachers, sir. Thank you. I am practicing at Chiprur. I did my pediatrics under Dr. Khare and Dr. Vishalakshan Karmarkar. Last 38 years I am practicing at Chiprur.
Dr. Rekha, can you? Rekha, please.
Hello.
Please.
Hello.
Yes, we can hear.
Rekha Sherbet Purvashramichi Valvekar, 74 bat MBBS. I did MD chest. 83 नंतर मी आता सगळ्यांना पहिल्यांदाच भेटतेय. सोटू सर, थॉमस सर, माझी इंटर्नशिप पण तिथे झाली होती आणि मेडिसिनची हाऊस पोस्ट मिशनला झाली होती. आणि श्यामसुंदर जोशींना तर कधीच विसरू शकत नाही, कारण रेडिओलॉजीचे बेसिक्स फंडे क्लिअर करण्यामध्ये त्यांचा हातखंडा होता. आता मी इथे शिरोळला दत्त शुगर फॅक्टरीच्या इथे काम करते सध्या.
जयंत चंद्रकांत सीजी गायकवाड, कॅन यू अनम्यूट? सतीश परांजपे, सतीश
झालं का अनम्यूट? हॅलो,
झालं अनम्यूट, झालं. आवाज येतो तुझा खणखणीत. येस,
ओके, सॉरी माझ्या इथे लाईट नाही आहे, सो यू मे नॉट बी सी लुकिंग माय फेस, डझंट मॅटर. जे बीजे शिंदे म्हणलं ते 6 लोक पास झाले, त्यातला मी एक तो दुर्दैवी पास झालेल्यातला होतो. कारण नंतर सरांचा म्हणजे सोरटू सरांचा किंवा एस के जोशींचा सत्संग लावला नाही. सरांना आम्ही खूप सोरटू सरांना खूप घाबरून असायचो, कारण म्हणजे आम्हाला कळायचंही काही नाही, येतही काही नव्हतं. फक्त त्यांच्या बरोबर फिरल्यामुळे जे काही चार शिंतोडे उडले ते पास झालो होतो. सकाळपासूनच सरांच्या या व्हिडिओचे अँग्झायटी म्हणा किंवा इगरली वी आर वेटिंग फॉर दॅट, थोडस कनेक्शन मध्ये प्रॉब्लेम आल्यामुळे झालं. परंतु खरंच दिस वॉज अ नॉस्टॉल्जिक आहे आणि मला वाटते 74 बॅच मध्ये हे काय म्हणून ही पद्धत चालू आहे. आणि गोप्या तुझे अत्यंत आभार, कारण असला उद्योग चालू केला आहे. आधी आम्हाला हे वापरता येत नाही आहे आणि दर रविवारी हे चालूच ठेव.
वी आर कंटिन्युईंग
म्हणजे ते लॉकडाऊन असू दे नाही तर नसू दे, दर रविवारी 9 ते 10 ही बॅटिंग करायची.
येस, फॅन्टॅस्टिक सजेशन. थँक्यू. विवेक पाटणकर, त्याच्या आधी बबीता घोडके. बबीता, यू कॅन स्पीक समथिंग, अनम्यूट युअरसेल्फ.
हा सर, मी डॉक्टर बबीता शिंदे घोडके आणि आय एम ऍक्च्युली 91 बॅच, 74 बॉर्न आणि GMC मिरज. दोन्हीकडे पोस्टिंग असायची, सिव्हिल हॉस्पिटल सांगली, वॉनलेस हॉस्पिटल मिरज. आणि MBBS करत असताना आय हॅड इंटरॅक्टेड विथ रिस्पेक्टेड डॉक्टर सी थॉमस सर वेन आय वॉज इन सेकंड फर्स्ट MBBS. सर वॉज द HOD अँड द होल आर्मी ऑफ द पूर्ण डिपार्टमेंट आणि त्याच्या एंडला आम्ही तीन न्यू सेकंड फर्स्ट एमबीबीएस चे स्टुडंट्स होतो. पण सर मेड इट अ पॉइंट टू कॉल अस अहेड अँड शो अस द पेशंट्स इन द आयसीयू विथ डिफरंट मर्मर्स. ही मेड अस टू ऑस्कल्टेट अँड वुड डिस्क्राइब द मिड डायस्टॉलिक अँड द पॅनसिस्टॉलिक मर्मर. नंतर सोरटूर सरांसोबत एमडी मेडिसिन झाल्यावरती मी 6 महिने सरांसोबत काम केलंय. आणि जी एस कुलकर्णी, मिरज माझं गाव असल्यामुळे जी एस कुलकर्णींच तर लाईक ही इज ऑलवेज बीन फेमस देअर. अँड सध्या मी आणि एस व्ही के सर दोघे पण आम्ही खारघर मध्येच प्रॅक्टिस करतोय. सो नाईस टू सी यू ऑल. थँक यू. ब्लेस यू ऑलवेज.
Arvind Kulkarni, you can please say something. Arvind Kulkarni is a practicing physician from Panvel. Chandrakant Gaikwad gela ka? Chandu? Chandrakant Gaikwad?
No. SV?
Yes, sir.
Already battery is almost over.
Okay, sir. Then we are going to, Dr. Vivek Patankar is going to sing a song for all of us. Vivek?
SV? Dr.
Yes. Sir,
wants to say something.
Yes, sir.
Huh.
Please. Please, sir.
Yes. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. Good evening, sir. Dr. Respected Dr. Sortu, sir. Dr. Thomas, sir. Dr. Yes Joshi, sir. Dr. Yes Kulkarni. Dr. Shyam Joshi, sir. Tumhara saglyana baghun mala khup khup anand hotoy.
विवेक एक दोन मिनिट सोटू सरांना बोलू देणार.
चालेल
बोलायचं नाही बट बॅटरी इज ऑलमोस्ट ओव्हर.
यस ओके सर प्लीज गो अहेड.
नाही बॅटरी इज ऑलमोस्ट इज ओव्हर.
देन डोंट हॅव बॅटरी फुल्ली चार्ज ऑन दिस फ्रायडे ऑल्सो. वी आर मीटिंग ऑन दिस फ्रायडे
31st.
And we have got a very surprise guest faculty. As enriching, as entertaining as what we had today. Vivek.
Hello.
Yes, Vivek, please go ahead.
मी 1972 बॅचचा स्टुडंट. मी सांगली सिव्हिल मध्ये आणि मिशन दोन्ही मध्ये होतो. एमडी मी 1983 ला पास केलं. आणि या सगळ्या सरांची लेक्चर्स म्हणजे सगळे एक ते बडकर एक सोटर सर काय थॉमस सर काय सगळ्यांची लेक्चर ऐकली आणि अशा सारखे टीचर लाभणे हे खरोखर आमचं सगळ्यांचं भाग्य होत. माझे सगळे मित्र मंडळी ज्युनियर आणि सिनियर दोघांनाही मी अभिनंदन करतो. आणि मी एक छोटस गाणं म्हणजे एक प्रार्थना आपला सादर करतो. सर्वात्मका सर्वेश्वरा सर्वात्मका सर्वेश्वरा गंगाधरा शिवासुंदरा गंगाधरा शिवासुंदरा जो जे जगी जगते तया जो दे जगते तया माझे म्हणा करुणा करा सर्वात्मका सर्वेश्वरा सर्वात्मका सर्वेश्वरा आदित तिमिरात भा आदित्यया तिमिरात भा युगतया हृदयात वा सृजनत्व द्या द्यार्यता सृजनत्व द्या द्यार्यता अनुदारिता दुरितहरा सर्वात्मका सर्वेश्वरा सर्वेश्वरा आ
सर्वात्मक सर्वेश्वरा सर्वेश्वरा
थैंक यू वेरी नाइस वेरी नाइस
थैंक यू थैंक यू थैंक यू सर
छान गाणं म्हटलं
यस यस वी
डॉक्टर जी एस के 89 and strong.
प्लीज नाही छान झालं सगळं कार्यक्रम अत्यंत आवडलं मला मला मागच्या स्टुडंट्सना बघून फार बरं वाटलं आणि असंच चालू ठेवा आणि पुढच्या केपेला आहेच परत आपण बोलू
August 31st, 1st January, August and 2nd August we have got 3 consecutive programs please inform all your friends and contacts and it can be watched on Facebook without any hesitation of login. Dr. S.K. Doshi, thank you very much. It has been absolutely a treat for everybody and it was a journey down right from Ranjan to the digital radiology. And we also appreciate help of our young friend Amol Maske who is sitting taking care of all the controls. Amol, thank you very much. And it is exactly now 1 hour and 52 minutes we are online. So I am stopping the recording, stopping the meeting. Those who have attended, I will send you a link of this recording. You can edit the video and watch whatever you want. And thanks a lot. See you on 31st, 31st July 58th. Happy birthday of Miraj Medical College. Thank you very much. Yes.
Thank you. Thank you. Yes. Thank you very much.
Yes, I stopped the recording.
SV, please. अरे मला ते थॉमस सर सोरोटो सर आणि जोशी सर ईमेल आय डी मागून घे ना
हो पाठवून देतो सगळ्यांचे सगळ्या माझ्याकडे एक्सेल शीट तयार आहे ती सगळीच पाठवून देतो
परफेक्ट परफेक्ट
थॉमस सरांची एकदम सोपी चेरियन थॉमस 43@gmail.com
काय काय मला
चेरियन थॉमस 43@gmail.com
ओके ओके परफेक्ट ओके
थँक्यू आय टेक
थँक्यू थँक्स अ लॉट रियल अप्रिशिएट ऑल युअर प्रेझेन्स रेकॉर्डिंग स्टॉप करायचं का क्लाउड वर बघायचं क्लिप रिंग हे
एक मिनिट करू ना स्टॉप करू
तू बघ ना आता फक्त लिंक आली तर लगेच पाठवून दे